what you got me out here doing. Now, we loved her in the classic TV sitcom Three's Company and her role as a widowed salon owner in the 90s hit Step by Step. But for American actress Suzanne Somers, real life recently took a frightening turn when an intruder stumbled into her home. Somers was in the middle of a live makeup tutorial at the time, and it was all caught on camera. Watch this.
How did you get here?
A friend led me up this hill, and then I came down.
Oh. Okay, you shouldn't be here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is our house.
But anyway, you don't scare me.
I've seen pictures of this house before.
Yeah, you shouldn't be here.
I'm not a scary person whatsoever.
I know, I'm not used to people being on our property.
Property.
Yeah, and we're doing a show right now. Yeah.
I apologize.
Okay, all right. So can you go
home? I do a show.
Can we cut the show a little short? Because I want to make sure we might have to call the police.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, all right. All is well. But thank you for your concern, everybody.
Cool as a cucumber. Suzanne joins us now from Los Angeles in the very spot this whole thing happened in. It's great to see you.
Exactly. Now, you see, Sarah, I believe in my Second Amendment rights, and I took training with Ranger Chuck, who said, if someone's on your property, they're there to do you no good. And then Ranger Chuck said, if someone is worth shooting once, they're worth shooting twice. Now, what saved this guy was that I looked over here. First, I thought he was my dinner guest coming very early, and then I realized, oh, no, those are not my dinner guests. The fact that he was essentially naked saved his life because I looked at him and I thought, there's no weapon. I can see everything on him. There's no weapon. And and by the way, if that was a weapon, not much of a weapon.
It can still do damage. It can still do damage. Yeah, you managed to stay very calm. Yeah, so there must have been...
You know, I do 3 times a week. You know, we've all tried to find our way to thrive and survive during this pandemic.
Yeah.
And I love working, I love what I do, and I've got my organic skincare line and hair care line and color makeup and certified toxic free everything, because that's the life I live. So I was in the middle of my show giving a tutorial about why it makes a difference if you use makeup that doesn't have chemicals in it, and then all of a sudden this guy walked in. What are the odds that someone would walk right into your shot? And then I realized, oh, you are so high, because he told me his name, and it was his name. He told me some intruder. So I'll tell you why I acted like that or reacted like that. And I've written 27 books besides the series I've done in Vegas and Broadway and all that stuff. One of the books that I wrote, one of the first books was called Keeping Secrets, about growing up the child of a violent, abusive alcoholic. And there are two ways you react when you are raised in abuse, whether it's drug addiction or alcoholism or whatever. You either crumble from fear, like my little brother who died, unfortunately, or you're like me at 5 years old when I realized I could control the situation, the crisis, it's called crisis mode, and that we would go into a closet at night. Imagine living in a house where we had to hide in the closet at night, but that's the life of children of alcoholics. And then you take care of everything and you keep everybody calm. So when this guy came here, that kicked in. I didn't even know that instinct was still in me, but there it was. And if ever you're in a crisis, you want me around, because I stay very, very calm in any kind of crisis. When it's over, I may fall apart. But during the crisis, I'm like, it's all okay. You're a nice person. You shouldn't be here. But then my husband, who we called Big Al, and by the way, this is Big Al's bar. We have our our shows 3 times a week at Big Al's bar.
To avoid having a crisis.
To avoid having a crisis. It's morning for you, but it's tequila time for us here. And if you go to SuzanneSomers.com, you can get a free hand sanitizer that won't dry out your hands if you buy one of these things today, hand wash, hand lotion. So it all worked out okay. We did call the police. Now, here's the interesting thing, and nobody knows. This is a scoop. His mother, I don't know if she was watching or if she saw what you saw in, because it kind of went viral. Mm. And she got a hold of the president of our company and said, that's my son. Wow. And he was an abused child. Aww. And he's a drug addict and he's in a bad relationship, because you don't, if you see, I live on 93 acres. I don't know what you call them in Australia, but 93 acres is a lot of land. He was naked with flip-flops, rubber flip-flops. That's not how you hike. Mm. And so he had to be high on something. And here in Palm Springs, there is a meth problem. I don't know what the ramifications of being a meth addict is, but I hear that you're bold and you'll walk into anything. And that's why the guy walked right into the set and told me his name. And then when I said, you shouldn't be here, he apologized.
It's quite amazing that you've got so much compassion for this man who essentially stormed onto your property, and that you can kind of see the good in him still. That's what makes you so likable. And also, Suzanne, you're a bit of a trailblazer. In fact, you posted a photo of yourself in your birthday suit to celebrate turning 73. Love this.
You know what? When I turned 65, I remember thinking, you can't lie about your age anymore with the internet. So forget that. I thought, I'm going to make my age the age that people want to be. And I'm enjoying how I'm aging. My most recent book is called A New Way to Age. And what I realized is that aging is about worn out parts. And the body's telling you all the time about your worn out parts. Maybe you're itching, or your hair's kind of stringy, or you don't have a sex drive, or you're moody, or whatever that language is, the body's saying to you something's missing. And so I write about, if you're experiencing worn out parts, like if you had a Maserati, you would never feed your Maserati inferior fuel, would you? And you would listen to all the little sounds your Maserati is making and then take it to a mechanic. We never do that with our bodies. So that's what I've been trying to do in my work, is make us all aware of what all this new crap they're putting in our food and putting in the air and putting in our skincare and putting in our makeup, what it's doing to us. And probably that guy who was right there is a victim of that. He grew up on food that was sprayed with poison. I don't know who thought it was a good idea to spray our food with poison, but I want to tell you something, my Australian friends. And tonight is one of them, I only consume Australian grass-fed organic lamb and beef, because you know down there something that we don't know here in America. We're putting stuff in our food here that is creating an epidemic that is out of proportion. So maybe that's where the compassion came from. But I'd like to live a long time. I'm 74 now, actually. And I didn't plan to take a naked picture of myself. We were walking on the property. And I saw all this tall, kind of blonde grass. And I said to my husband, oh my gosh, this grass is the same color as my hair. So I sat down in the grass and I pulled my hair into the grass and pulled my top down, not thinking this was ever going to be seen all over the world. And then women loved me for that, for saying, you know what? It just because you're getting older doesn't mean you're not getting better.
Yeah.
It's how you take care of yourself.
You are like a fine wine. We would love to keep talking to you, but we've run out of time. You must come back sometime soon, Suzanne Somers. We love you.
Let's do it again. And when I'm eating my lamb chops, I'll think of all of you. Good night.
Good luck again to that tutorial.